I enjoy fitness because I look at it as a tool to teach myself confidence. I set fitness goals for myself because I found that without them, I struggle. My enthusiasm for most other aspects of life diminishes because fitness is what gets me going. It's one of my go-to habits that just, it really picks me up in other aspects of my life. If I'm not sure, you know, how to get this this task done at work, or you know, how to handle this situation with you know, a disagreement with a friend or whatever it is, you know, a lot of those stresses that aren't so clear, fitness is one of the things that I've always been able to go back to and just trust in it, like, because I know what I'm doing when it comes to fitness. So I can go to my comfort zone, if you will, and recharge for a little bit, and then go, you know, feel like I can take on the world again. I actually grew up in a small town in Ohio called Steubenville. It's about a half hour or so outside of Pittsburgh, PA. You know, I started playing sports when I was about 3 or 4, and never stopped. I did baseball, football, wrestling, track, cross country. I picked up my first set of weights when I was about 11 or 12 years old, and used to work out with my dad on a regular basis in our basement. Initially, he probably put a little bit more pressure on me to stick with it. He was a sports-minded guy, but within a short period of time, I learned to thank him for it because of all the lessons that it taught me and the discipline, you know, that came from that type of training. I think just recently, I finally figured out what does make me tick, and that is to get up and to serve Jesus Christ and to live my life for Him, because I've learned over time that any other pursuit is just, it doesn't add up, you know. Our life is finite. You know, we have a set number of days on this planet. When you can really get a grasp on the eternal perspective, you know, your perspective changes on what matters. There are things that I don't know as much about. For instance, running my own gym. You know, I'm not as knowledgeable in that area. I don't have as much experience in that area. But going back to, you know, when I originally learned how to train for a specific event or a competition or anything like that, those things are really simple to me at this point. It's, you know, you do this, this, and this, and this will happen. Now, a lot of things in life aren't that clear cut, but by putting those same principles into practice, you got to start somewhere. You got to start somewhere, and it might seem like, you know, an unbearable task or impossible to achieve, but you got to start with step number one. I hope to teach people about themselves, to teach people that they can achieve far more than they ever thought they could. Now, fitness might be the initial tool to teach people, you know, how to transform themselves, how to you know, increase their strength, lose weight, increase energy, things like that, things that they might have never experienced before. In addition to that, you know, I want them to take those things that they learn through fitness and apply them to everything else in their life. You know, for someone who may have never been fit in their life, it seems like an impossibility. And then when you get there, when you get one step closer and another step closer, and then you eventually get there, you're looking back, it's almost like, hey, you know, how did I do this? I think you can carry that over to the next time that you face some sort of challenge or opposition that you didn't think you could handle. And you look at it with a little bit more confidence than you did before, because you know, once upon a time, you know, I didn't think I could do 20 push-ups, or I didn't think I could make it up the incline, but you did. So it gives you, I think it can give people hope in a variety of situations. My name is Cody Moore, and I am a Kairos alumni.